Hey everybody, Greg Taylor, Trinity Web Media. So thanks for watching. Thanks for checking out our Instagram TV, YouTube, and the new marketing show bonus edition. So we've been talking a lot about blogging, and I wanted to just kind of go back and talk about, you know, I fell in love with WordPress through blogging and Matt Mullenweg's ideal of how WordPress democratized publishing. And I always felt like I had something to say. I didn't feel like I had a platform to say it until I found WordPress. And so the two things kind of went hand in hand, and that's where I started really, really diving into WordPress and WordPress development. But if you think about it from a content aspect, the blog is still the center of your content strategy because that's where everything goes to, and that's where you're publishing things. You know, even if you have a strong social strategy, you know, you want to still own and control the destiny of your message and your brand and your content. It all goes back to your website, and the component of your website where it goes is your blog. So we use the analogy always that your website is the sun of the solar system. It's the same. It's the same for your content strategy. The blog is the sun of that solar system. So it's one of the things that you have to make sure it's optimized. Make sure that you're delivering content that people want, that people that will help people, that helps your brand. And a lot of people, you know, have like blogs that are altruistic, you know, just to give away information. Maybe it's an event thing or a how-to, a DIY type thing. It always brings back some, it brings them back somehow to the brand because they're providing value for free. It's sort of like the content marketing's freemium model. You know, you subscribe to this thing and you get X amount of features, you know, like an app or something like that. And then if you pay, you get, you know, all the features. So the blog is like the introduction to your brand. And if you think of it like a freemium model, that, you know, if you post a lot of content to be helpful and whatnot, you know, that could be a gateway to consulting. Or you post a lot of content about WordPress development or content marketing, that could be a gateway to contract engagements. So it's a lot of different stuff. And also, I use blogging just to exercise my voice, like I said in the beginning. I publish a lot to Medium, more of my personal thoughts and stuff that aren't appropriate for the business stuff, only because our business audience is so, you know, cut and dry that I don't want to go there and kind of muddy the waters with what they've expected from me and from Trinity, you know, over the years. So I think that, you know, again, if you take anything from this, just respect your blog. Treat it with the respect that it deserves. You know, schedule time for it to make sure that it's optimized. Make sure you're given the right content. Make sure you have a various types of content on it. Make sure that you have, you know, video, audio, imagery, you know, the written word, of course. All of that stuff goes there. You know, a lot of times we talk about blogging, people get so focused on, well, we just post, you just write posts. Well, no, we post these videos. We post our podcast there. We post a lot of other things to bring people in. So the blogging is sort of like the 101, the slow lane to, you know, to the accelerator to get you up and running with your content strategy. So if you don't have a blog right now on your website, go ahead and launch one. And don't worry about what you're gonna write. You know, think about what questions clients ask you. Think about what problems you're solving. Write about that. That's a great start for any blog. So respect your blog, make sure you have one, make sure it's optimized, treat it with the respected commands. Hey, thanks for watching, thanks for listening. We really appreciate you, and see us next time. Thanks.